In our course, deep breathing has a lot to do with our sound production. And because we have dialogues, we have to read out the text. So we know our body, our instrument of the sound, so we know how to, where to strike the note and how to deliver it, what are the pauses, what is the blocking, okay. And then of course all of us will put things together to make it a full product. And for that, so we have six. Now we come to the play Tara. And before that, I would like to talk a little bit about Mahesh Bhattani's plays, so that you understand what kind of playwright he is, and what kind of voice acting, acting through voice listening, that how you create imagery out of voice. That will be a different challenge here, because in proscenium you can use props, and you can wear clothes, and you can put makeup. But here, each and everything that you do for creating the drama is the sound. So you have to speak your makeup through sound. You have to speak your clothes through sound, your costume through sound, light also through sound. So sound is the only raw material with us for making a radio play.
What is, do you want me to make music?
Huh?
Okay. I'm supposed to make sounds.
Oh, yes.
Okay, wait a second. Okay.
Yes. Now we come to Mahesh Bhattani playwriting and this play Tara. So I just let you know that Mahesh Bhattani is a contemporary playwright, and he now lives in Bombay. Earlier he spent number of years in Bangalore writing plays. He is an Indian English playwright, and the development of his theatrical art is in the 80s, 90s and onward. So we may say that he is a writer who comes from the history of Indian English theatre post 80s of India. And then he worked, he did not come from the field of art or theatre. He came from the background of commerce and then MBA management, and then he worked in some corporate companies doing marketing and other kinds of jobs. But at the same time, but you see, right from his school education, he had developed taste for theater. And theater for him became something as a hobby, but that he explored more and more, and he found it more interesting and more meaningful for his objectives and vision, and also for his livelihood. So he developed himself as an actor by acting in plays directed by other people, and at the same time he explored his own directional abilities and skills that he kept on adding. And this is how, you see, he comes into, he becomes a playwright, actor, director, and script writer, as well as a radio play writer. And for that, you see, for him, theater is something very, very different, which means that he does not write his plays for reading. He writes his plays for seeing and listening, or for watching and listening. That's why he does not write his plays sitting alone and putting a piece of paper on the table. But he conducts workshops with his actors, and during that he develops his play. So his art of writing is also workshop based, and that's more like you are making furniture as a carpenter in your own workshop. So you see, there is a difference between being in a workshop as a carpenter and making furniture. So he, in that true sense, is a playwright, W-R-I-G-H-T, not a drama writer, W-R-I-T-E-R. So he is a writer, W-R-I-G-H-T. That means that he works more like as an artisan with his art, not just as a thinker, a thinker of art. Now this is one area. The second important thing, so he has written his he has developed his theater or plays on a very certain specific area, and that is, he does not tell stories which have been told, or which everyone can tell, or which can be told. He prefers to tell stories which are hidden, put under the carpet, or are taboos, that is untalkable, or there are, you know, social bans, and there are political, you know, issues, and people won't talk about those areas. So he takes up those issues in his plays, where he deals with those dramas, those real life actions which happen in society but are not talked, and their fissures, fractures, and holes of reality are not shown, they are not discussed. So we exercise this kind of thing in India. That is our social experience or political experience, that we would not like to talk something that we have suffered, or we would not like to talk about, let us say, some hidden areas, for example, depression or mental health or sexual health, or exploring body at different stages of life, or our fantasies, or our desires, or, you know, the way individuals sometimes think of their gender. Okay, so you see, Mahesh Dattani takes up these issues in his plays. This is very important. The second thing is the characters that we will notice in this play. So they struggle, and they want some kind of freedom, happiness under the weight of tradition, culture, cultural construction of gender, and repressed desire. So this is another, you know, area. So we may see that our village, society, and the people live there. So unless they are urbanized, they have their village-oriented psychology, village-oriented problems, and their sense of freedom or happiness, and their, are they under the weight of tradition or cultural construction of gender, and what are the repressed desires. But the urban space and the modern space among the educated people, it creates altogether a very different drama, a very different drama of human life. And now these dramas are played out on multiple levels, multiple sets. Now, when we start reading out or understanding Tara, we will understand that this is also a play which is set on multiple, multi-level sets. Okay, we must understand that what does it mean? And then in radio play, it will be more interesting how to create multi-level sets. Okay, how to create a memory or an episode in radio play, how to create the present, how to create the past, and how to create the future. So how to really create different tenses or different segments of time in radio play, that would be also challenging, because in of course in when we stage play in proscenium or in the real on the real stage, we visualize the time through costume, through light, through language. Okay, and here also we have to see how to visualize it. So this in his plays, multi-level sets where interior and exterior become one. This is important. Interior and exterior of a theme or of a character. Okay. And which means that it's very difficult to hide the interior from the exterior and exterior from the interior. This means that the way we look, for example, when we present ourselves to a social space, we have an appearance, and we allow our interior to be visible to the extent that we want. So maybe 80%, 90% of our interior is not visible to somebody whom we are meeting. But Mahesh Dattani will reveal the interior and exterior together as one, because he is dealing with drama that does not hide but expose what has been hidden. So as you know, when we are sick and when we go to a doctor, so we can't hide our interior. Okay, we have to tell everything about our feeling, what are we undergoing, and so on and so forth. And sometimes, you know, the doctor may also take certain technical equipments and to understand the interior of your physical existence. But in drama, no doubt this interior is more a psychological space, okay? And where the repressed desires or the desires that have not been expressed or have been protected or denied, okay, are there, and he has to expose them. So this, his geographical location, therefore, will collapse. The geographical location of the exterior and interior of his characters or ideas will collapse and will not protect each other. In short, his settings are as fragmented as the families who inhabit them. So therefore, he is not showing a continuous reality. That continuous reality is only possible when you have hidden the holes and the gaps and the cracks and the fissures and the fractures. When you hide them, then it seems to be very continuous. In reality, nothing is continuous. All of us have fractures, psychological gaps, holes, and ruptures. The only thing is that we present ourselves in a manner that we seem or appear to be a continuous kind of stable person. So he exposes this stability of characters and shows that for this kind of expression. And so he takes the invisible issues. So this is the point that he takes the invisible issues. The invisible issues are within us, in our psychology, in the society, in the kind of environment we live, and he exposes them on the stage or through the drama for the audience to see that we are not as continuous and complete and stable as we present ourselves. That this is how this playwright sees his world, and this is how he creates his drama. And so we can understand the purpose of his drama is altogether very different. Okay, and this is how he has written his plays. He has why does the world recognize him as one of the greatest Indian English playwrights is because of this, that he is not afraid of telling something or creating a story that would shake the world. So he is not a spectacle creator. No, he is not the kind of person who will take a story that will create a spectacle. Okay? No, not a human error or human flaw or human weakness of the character. No, he is not really into that. He is into how human beings are created psychologically, socially, culturally, and what are the things that are hidden from them, what are the things that are injected into them. So he is a playwright of such themes. So this will create the issues that is he as a playwright, how does he handle the tradition in his play, how does he handle the idea of a nation, idea of being Indian, for example. I mean, does it mean that I'm Indian if I say something which is a taboo in my society? So when I'm saying something which is a taboo, other people will say, no, we don't think like this in India, or we don't think we don't expose things like this in our society. So we keep on speaking that this is what we speak in our society and this is what we don't speak in our society. So you know, these issues will become very important, that when you say something, how does suddenly you become un-Indian, and when you say something, then how do you become suddenly an Indian? So he takes up this issue. Tara's play centers on the emotional separation that grows between two conjoined twins following the discovery of their physical separation, was manipulated by their mother and grandfather to favor the boy Chandan over the girl Tara. Now this is the plot. What is the plot? Can you now tell me? Tara as a play. Now there is an emotional separation that grows between two conjoined twins. Now, this is a twin, one is male, the other is female, biologically. And the discovery that their physical separation, and then they have to be separated by means of modern science, okay? And when the separation takes, the manipulation happens. Why? Because one of them is a male, one other is a female, so our social prejudices, our social ideas, they start participating. Who should get leg, why, how will it affect the male, how it will it affect the female, and you see all that. And that manipulation happens between their mother and grandfather, and that favors boy Chandan. So this is the plot. of this place. Now, what happens in the story that Tara does not survive, and Chandan comes to know about, later he comes to know about how he was favored, and this becomes a guilt in him. And so you see, this story, this play, I mean, becomes a drama of emotional separation of two characters who were born as one. So the separation and guilt, and that guilt later on takes Chandan then abandons India and goes UK and settles there, but he wants to tell this story which is in the memory of Tara. And he is half without Tara, and by telling this story he wants to achieve his fullness. And so this play therefore is a story which is a taboo otherwise. I mean, generally Indian homes do not discuss the favors they give to their male children, and this favors they give to their female children. They don't discuss, they don't talk about it outside. So their interior, the interior of their gender manipulation, interior of their gender disparity is hidden, and it keeps on hidden for 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years. And then next generation comes and that also hides. And this is how generation after generation, the gender is constructed, which creates more male, more powerful, and female, less powerful, or not a real decisive stakeholder in the decision-making process. Okay. And so you see, in that sense, this is a very, very interesting play. And Tara, therefore, who was not given opportunities, eventually wastes away. And Chandan escapes to London, changes his name to Dan. Chandan becomes, changes his name to Dan. This is a character. An attempt to repress the guilt he feels over his sister's death by living without a personal map history. And he becomes, you know, as most of people in from India, when they go to Europe or settle somewhere, they have to live without a personal history. And in his case, it's a very, very different kind of thing. He cannot tell it to anyone. This is the problem. He cannot tell that this is how he was separated from Tara. And while separation happened, manipulation because of gender disparity in our society happened. And that led to the immature death of Tara. And that guilt is with him all the time. And so you understand the dramatic tension here. What is the dramatic tension in this play? And he feels over his sister's death by living without a personal personal history. And okay. So woven into the play are issues of class and community, and the clash between traditional and modern lifestyles and values, and so on and so forth. Okay. So I think you are getting, you have got this this idea. What is this play? What is the issue? And how we need to understand ourselves in terms of voice and other ingredients that we can put within this play.